Jack assures me that he is going to work to make at least one letter legible.
President Obama teased the new Treasury Secretary after seeing his curly Q signature. Look at it. This is a signature. This is going to be on all legal currency. Can you see any actual letters in there? On all levels, the signature and cursive handwriting are in danger of fading away. Here in Minnesota, schools are no longer required to teach cursive. It's not just the signature, though, that's taking a hit. The way that students learn and brains develop could suffer.
This is a slide of cursive I, which
Ms. Tyson uses the latest technology to teach her third grade class old-fashioned cursive handwriting at Concord Elementary School in Edina.
It's about the marriage of technology, like the old school and the new school have to come together.
But they appear headed for divorce. Several states, including Illinois, Indiana, and Hawaii, don't teach cursive. Minnesota no longer requires schools to teach cursive. The Department of Education tells us most districts still choose to teach it, but they spend less time on the cursive because kids are using keyboards much more.
I don't think that anybody would say that cursive writing shouldn't be taught, and I don't think that we'll ever lose it. I think the question is, what role does it play as we think about the skills that kids need in the 21st century?
Blame those 21st century skills for causing the split between cursive and class time. The state follows a national standard called the Common Core. It says students must know keyboarding by fifth grade, but doesn't even mention cursive. At least 46 states have adopted the standards.
It just kind of feels fancy.
So most Minnesota kids are learning that fancy cursive in second or third grade. But by fifth grade, they turn to typing full time, and most never have to look back. Researchers say it's not about whether typing or cursive is more important. Learning cursive actually helps a child's brain development.
Why don't we just try that A that you were...
Pat Nyberg is a writing expert.
They have done CAT scans of people actually writing. There's much more activity going on in the brain when you're actually writing.
Doctors at Indiana University used MRIs to look at children's brains and found more activity when they were writing versus typing. And researchers from Vanderbilt got similar results, seeing kids' brains light up less in front of a keyboard. Doctors say cursive handwriting, more than printing, stimulates intelligence and language fluency.
If the teacher's listing a bunch of spelling words for a child, then by writing it down, they retain it much more.
The teachers don't have enough time.
Beth Engel brought her son Andrew to see Nyberg to help with his printing last year.
And travel way and up.
Now he's in fourth grade and struggling with cursive.
I don't use it.
No, why not?
Because it's too hard.
But his mom's less concerned.
No, I've kind of gone back and forth with that. You know, with the way the world is going in the digital age, you don't need as much handwriting.
Nyberg disagrees. Fluent writing keeps kids from truncating their thoughts, and kids will soon be adults who need a distinct signature.
Excellent. Then what are we going to use? Do we just put an X there, or do we use a thumbprint?
Writing print.
Well, the Department of Education tells us that they are always reevaluating their policies. In fact, they say they may reexamine their cursive policy if schools, in fact, stop using it. Bill?